What's up, guys? How's it going? And welcome to Cities Skylines After Dark Edition. So, I know we had a series on Cities Skylines last year, featuring Whiteburg City, but I thought, okay, this city isn't great. I've come a long way since then, and I've got a whole new ideas to show you guys. So, I thought, why not start a brand new city in a brand new world, and, you know, get you guys involved with what you can do. Oh my god, this is beautiful. Wow, I haven't seen this yet. This is some crazy-looking junction. It's massive. Okay, so I'm playing on some really nice custom map. This isn't part of the game, and it was made by someone on Steam. I'll put the link in the description below. I can't remember who made it now. But, yeah, I want you guys to come up with a name for this city, so I don't have to, because I'll just call it Whiteburg or something Berg again. We're all sick and tired of that, so you guys can come up with a name that will suit this area. So we got this nice big river that comes up through, and then we've got sort of, it splits off into two with this middle headland bit, which is where they want us to start building. So yeah, this series is going to be kind of a bit jumpy and stuff. I'm going to do a bit off camera, a bit on camera, and you know, it's just going to help the flow, I think, because last time I think it stagnated a little bit because we had a lot going on and I wasn't really sure what I was doing. But this time I've got some new ideas and I kind of just want to play them through and see how we do it. Okay, so we're going to start off in this area around here. So this is sort of like a big headland bit. I know there's a lot of farmland here, but I don't think we're going to end up using it because this is where I want the main city to be, unless we somehow manage to get over to this island here, but I'm not too sure about that. So we're going to start off by, obviously, you know, first things first, bringing across the roads. So there's been another update, I think, since I last played, and they've got these new tiny roads, which I've never seen before. So we are obviously playing England style, so that means driving on the left, but I think we're in a tropical region, maybe. Oh no. Yes, that's right. Hang on, I was like, what's going on there? So just bring that round there. So we've now got this one-way street, and as always, well, actually, not as always, because you guys haven't seen this yet, but recently I've started using a lot of roundabouts, because roundabouts are just the king. This is mainly because we built one on Minecraft, like some absolutely amazing one, and I kind of just wanted to keep the flow going. But roundabouts are beautiful, so I know it's not going to look great at the moment, but it's because we haven't really got any money, and we're just sort of starting out, so I'm going to stick a roundabout there. And now, what I've started doing with City Skylines is sticking roundabouts where I think main areas are going to be. So we're going to have a roundabout there and then one across the river later on, so we have a bridge across there, nice big bridge. So we got this one and a road will connect up to there. I think maybe another one up over in this section. So this is just kind of a way of me planning out what's going on. I've got a few mods on, as you can sort of tell. So I've got the no pillars mod, the one that stops the daylight changing, so we've got it permaday, unless I want to show you some guy stuff. So we'll keep it on permaday for now, and yeah, just lots of little things that I've got in the city that we can use. So I'm going to start using these where are they, dirt roads there. So we're going to start using these dirt roads just to plan out a little bit of the city. Okay, so what I want to do is take this road and make it nice and straight up to about there, and then we'll have it on a freehand. We'll have it bend round like that, and so we may have to move that roundabout actually. Okay, so this is kind of what we're getting at. So I want this area to feel a bit older. We can all start to build, you know, big grid sections up around here, but this area I want to feel nice and old, nice and sort of I don't know, maybe a little medieval, so roads aren't exactly all straight and narrow. So bringing that one down like that, and yeah, so we should really start planning out our actual sort of little city at the moment. So this is obviously going to be a big sort of crossroad area where a lot of things go on, so we could have like a little road that goes across there later on, but for now I need to get back to here actually and start adding in some little roads. Okay, so yeah guys, last year I wasn't amazing. The first time I played it was pretty much for those videos. So I was learning as I was going through, and it wasn't the best, let's just say. So I've come a long way from that, I'm not going to lie. And you'll be able to see that throughout these videos. So I'm upgrading these to some roads that I've got as a mod. So these are like different roads. We've got three lane, small heavy roads. So this is going to act as like a nice big, heavy duty sort of roundabout for now. So what we got going on is good. Eventually, I'm going to raise that highway up again and bring it so it comes sort of this way round here, and then maybe somehow, I don't know, or we can have it come across that way through the city. I'm not too sure yet, but somehow we got to make it go over there. So this is like our main road going through the city. And then off of this, we'll start putting some other little lanes. But these are like the old roads. So these are the more medieval ones. So if we sort of bring this down, so we can have some sort of industry around this area, maybe just quickly while we're trying to set up, and then maybe move industry somewhere else later on. So we have that road like that, and it will end up going to maybe some docks here or a bridge across. So it's quite nice at the moment. Eventually, yeah, we'll bring this highway out. We probably might even have to make another junction down here on the highway to fill up this area. Well, obviously we will have it come across there somehow. Railway line we need to bring in. So I'm kind of just planning as we're going. I don't want to, you know, overthink things because then it will ruin the game. But should we just start by upgrading? I want to upgrade this road here to sort of a heavy duty small road. So there we go. We can bring that out that way. And maybe get something that goes down like that. So I'm going to start drawing in a few little plots. So bear with me here. Yeah, I kind of want to go for a gridded sort of area. I think grids work, but only if you don't do too many of them, or else it looks bad. So we kind of messed up a little bit there, but not to worry, we don't have to have this road, so let's do that. Okay, so let's stick a few houses in. So the houses can go around here, and we can put a few shops up here, actually, because that's like sort of the main road in. Not sure what traffic's going to be like at the moment, but I imagine it's going to be horrible. But I'm liking this, actually. It's a nice little setup. So Old Town is going to be more around this section here, so sort of along the coast. Thinking about putting some docks in if we can, or some interesting features down here. So this is going to be more medieval roads. This here is a bit more Victorian, a bit more planned out. So let's put this down here, because we said we're going to put our sort of industry this way, which means we're going to have to need to bring up some power lines to here. Now, the only issue with that is we haven't got anything along this road to take the power. So let's do that, and then do that. So is that going to jump? Can we jump that? Okay, maybe we just put one across the road, like so. Okay, so they're going to start getting power now. And the water issue is going to be fun, because we've now run out of money. Excellent. Okay, is that's working. Right, good. Good stuff, because we know how difficult this game is, don't we, guys? And we know how much fun you can have just really messing about. So let's plug that in. So we got all the basic amenities in. Excellent. So we aren't going to fail just yet. But I don't know what it's called yet, because we haven't got a name for it. So, guys, come up with a name for it as soon as you can. I'm going to do these episodes one by one, so I'll put out a video and then you guys can say what's right and what's wrong about it, and then you can choose what we do. Oh, damn. Okay. We're going to have to stick our industry somewhere a little bit closer, because we haven't got any water over there. So for now, we're going to have to stick our industry here. Now, bear with me on this. We don't have to keep it here, but as soon as we start making some cash, some dollar bills, we can start moving stuff. So let's get a... Is that... I've got some water there as well? Yes, it does. That just about covers that. Okay, so let me just remove all of these down here. Eventually, we'll move it so industry can either go over here where all these fields are, start farming properly, have it all along the bank, so, you know, lots of ways in and out of the city. Oh yeah, look at that. So we're starting to get our industry coming in now, which is good. The only bad thing is this poor guy here, what's his name, the Holly residence, has to live on a dirt road right next to a big stinking factory. Good work, Mr. White. You're the best mayor ever. Well, you know, people have to, you know, what's the word, accept that hard times have come upon us. We only just started up, We're all running away from Whiteberg, as everyone does, and we're trying to start a new life over here. So I will end up changing the route of the highway. I don't like how it is now. So it'll come round and it'll swoop down through the old city and across to this island, which would be quite a hub of activity as well. We could have the CBD over this side, actually. Maybe bypass the old town completely with stuff. But railway lines, I want to bring track down here, get a terminus set up somewhere. Same again here. So we have two termini doing stuff. Okay, so the cash is not flowing in, and we are pretty much going to come to a standstill in a minute until our industry starts growing. So we've got these nice little trees. I like this because it was obviously a fields. We've got these trees going on here doing stuff. Speeding through time a little bit. Roundabout's working nicely. So this is always good. Always good practice to put a roundabout where you know you're going to have heavy traffic. I can already tell this area is going to be stupidly busy, but this is old. So bear with, guys. It has to be old. So it has to look old. And old things don't work properly. You know, I'm not talking about your grandparents. I'm just talking about, you know, old things break. And their ideas of, you know, city layout 200-300 years ago did not include cars. So you got to think about that. That when you're building your roads, if you're building sort of a medieval area, everything's going to be hickety-pickety. It's just where people started walking one day. And then they went, oh, we can just pave that over. There you go. History lesson 101 with Mr. White. You know, understanding old city layouts. It's just the way they thought back then. Okay, so we're crawling back out the hole slightly. Okay, right, guys, we've taken the loan out and we're no longer bankrupt, but we aren't making money. So what I'm going to have to do is set up our industry proper over here. So that means start sucking up some water from somewhere around here, bringing it up into there, and kicking out some sewage as well. So just get that up there. We need to get some power lines down, like so, and I need to upgrade some roads. So let's turn this into a proper road. Right, so we come down to this little tip here, and I think we can just sort of do something like this. Oh, I don't really know how to use the bend tool. So let me take that back a little bit. Not really sure what I'm trying to do here. So I want like a 90 degree bend there. And we'll have it come back up that way. Perfect. So in around here we can start laying out some grids for industry. So we're trying like that. So I hope you guys are wanting another City Skylines series, because you know, I do enjoy playing this game and I love to show you what I'm doing rather than just me playing and not letting anyone see. It's like, no, you can't see what's going on. So I would like you guys to get interested with it. It's a fun game, and it's a hard fun game. So, you know, you get a good thrill out of it, but it takes a lot of work. So let's get those out of there. You're out of here. And let's upgrade this road, actually, because I know this one's going to be quite busy. So we've just cut off the water supply to the entire city, which is always good. Actually, I can do that and connect it. Excellent. So that should be filling back up with that. Okay, let's think about this area up here. Since, oh no, we've run out of money again. Not to worry. Back to square one. Let's just put some more roads in and a bit more water before we literally die on our feet. So it's going to have to be dirt roads again, guys. I'm so sorry, but you guys are going to have to keep washing your cars weekly now. Alright. 90 degrees, 90 degrees, and in with a 45. Look at that. It looks good. Now we've got this grid pattern going on. Is that one going to come through like that? No, these ones just going to stay like this. Oh. No, I don't want that one there. Okay, so once we get some money again, we can start planning things out properly. I know, I'm really worried that we aren't ever going to get any money, but we should. We should start getting a bit of dollar. But yeah, I'm quite meticulous with my city planning, actually, at the moment, because I don't know if you know, but we have got our Minecraft city, and it's really nice. It's I made a brand new map for it, and I sort of planned it on something I did in City Skylines, so roundabouts and highways and stuff. and it looks really great. So, you know, check out our videos on that on our channel. I think I'll put one up on the cards right now to pop up. But, oh, look at that, guys. So we've actually hit an area where we can take out some loans. So that's good, a little hamlet. Let's get some stuff put in, like a school. So let's take out that loan of 20 grand, small loan of 20 grand, and let's set up some more roads, actually, to get a new school on. So if we start planning this way a little bit, I kind of want a road that does go parallel to that one, and we'll get a area like that behind. So that's looking good. Also, I'm going to just bring this road this way, and it can then intersect here, so like that. And also, just to finish this road off, because it's annoying me, I know we just got a bit of money now, that road can go all the way up round the back there underneath the highway. So we got this sort of area coming together now, and this is going to look so nice once we start putting grid structures in there. Okay, for now we're going to stick our landfill right on the tip right on the tip of the island, if we can. Oh, no, that's right on the tip. I don't want it there. Okay, let's stick it there. Hopefully, it won't cause too much of an issue. But we're still hemorrhaging money. Hemorrhaging quite badly. I mean, literally, we're bleeding money out. Well, that's what it means. So, let's stick another road in there. So, this one doesn't have to go all the way down through. It can stop like that. But it will go up this way, let's say. And intersect with that road there. So we're kind of going for a nice, neat design. I wouldn't say it's going to be the best, because, like I was explaining to you, the history of why city plans are like they are. But this one looks quite nice, actually. I want to go for something that's workable and also looks good. So, yes. Let's stick a few more shops along this main avenue. So we're going to have a couple of main avenues that have shops along, this being one of them. And I think we'll double up that one, make this like a shopping area, so we'll have this as like a different town. And once I make a little bit more money, once we start making some money, I'll set up a little hamlet around here. So that's kind of another way I like doing things, because cities aren't just grown out of nowhere. They're grown out of a need to bring two communities together, or two or more, to trade and stuff. So you'll understand that I will start building little settlements around, and the idea is the roads and all of that connect together, and that's the reason we have roads. So again, I'm still going for my history lesson while drinking some coffee. I feel like a right teacher actually today. What do people need? Education is what they need. So we've got these cool little schools that are part of, what's it called? Part of a pack. Well, not a pack, just part of a download, so it's from the community. So I'm going to fill up the area around that with some more hooses for the mooses, and some more hooses down there as well. This area can then become a bit of a shopping area, like I was talking about. So I always build my shops at the moment randomly, just on corners and stuff, but they don't always seem to be the best plots, and you know, shops need to grow big and strong. These ones won't, but never fear, we will have a nice big shopping area somewhere soon. This is just us getting set up and ready. I keep reassuring you, but I'm actually reassuring myself, because I'm really like, I don't like this setup at the moment, because the highway's doing something weird, and I don't like how the highway's doing it. Right, hopefully we'll start making some money now. I've just put some houses in. Oh, do you see that, guys? We're nearly in the green. Only losing $400 per hour now. And if I quickly go into this first person mode, we can have a little drive around while we're waiting to earn some money. So look at all these dusty little back streets. These are going to form, okay, so people are just parking their Lamborghinis on the side of dusty streets. But this is going to form, obviously, you know, the nice grid-like structure of whatever we're calling our city. I know, I need to rename places soon. But we can make districts. And can we make districts? No, not yet. We will make districts once we get 1,000 people living here, which is soon. I'm thinking Wick something, maybe Wick. I like the name Wick. It means like river or town or something in some language. More history lessons for me. Someone's sick. But I'm sorry, but we can't help you, love. You're gonna have to die. I know I sound like a horrible mayor, but I cannot afford to help you. I can't build your medical thing yet. So we're gonna start paving up our streets. Look at that. So another top tip from me is always start out with dirt roads. They're cheap, they're easy, and you can get an understanding of what you want. Alright? What you want, mate. So we're just going to start putting these in here. So these people finally deserve to have proper streets. We're now at Worthy Village. Ah, excellent. Okay, so I can quickly get a second loan and get us some stuff. And then we can start wrapping this first episode up, maybe. So let's get a medical center, medical clinic. Where do we want this? So we got our school down there. Medical clinic can kind of, I don't want it on the main road, because this is another thing, guys. You don't put your poppables on main roads until you've fully upgraded that road. So, you know, it just makes a little bit more sense. So we could have this down by the school around there. And that means I can upgrade this area to being a bit more hoosie-like. Get some pipes in there. Let's bring that down. Make sure it's all gridgy light. And bring that right down. Because we can now bring in this road through here, maybe. Is that going to be... I don't know. Is that a sensible idea? Let's have a look. Yeah, that's a sensible idea. Okay, so sorry, houses, but you're going to have to die. Okay, so this area could start forming part of a park, maybe. Or I could start... Oh, no, we've run out of money again. We still aren't making money. Guys, what is wrong? Start selling your stuff. Maybe you haven't got enough shops to buy your wares in. Okay, right. Let's fill up this area here with shops. So let me take out a second loan of 60,000. And we can start putting in our first fire station. So that's police station. Hang on. Where's fire? There's fire. So we go for one of these fire hoses. And we'll sort of stick it somewhere. Where should we stick it? Maybe right up that arse there? I don't know. Stick it on that corner there. That isn't an important road yet. Yes, obviously firemen need their water. So we can stick it there. You can set policies and make a district. Okay, excellent. So we are going to stick with sort of the naming aspects of things from my actual Minecraft world. So this area here, before we even start, this area here is going to be known as Lindenville. And that can be all of that area in between those roads and along the river there. So that's going to be Lindenville. This here is going to be Newburgh, as it always is. Everyone who's watching, who knows me and knows how I like naming things, will understand. That is Newburgh. So Newburgh's going to be quite extensive, and it'll take up a lot of this, but for now it's just going to be that. This area here is where I was going to say we can start like a little settlement, maybe. So we'll kind of do like a circle, and maybe a bit like that, and yeah, we could keep maybe Forest Park. I was thinking maybe Wick Street or something. And then this can be our industry area. And we can call that something. What's it going to pop up with? Let's have a look. So we got that going on. So that's Coldridge Heights. Maybe not. And actually, I think I'll put Newburgh in there a bit more. And let's just tidy that up along the riverbank. Don't be so messy. This road will be used a lot. So just to avoid any issues, we're going to upgrade that to big roads straight away. So we're not going six lane just yet, we're just going to go four lane with turning angles. So that'll be fine. I can do that. That one can be like that. We'll actually have the same here. Don't need it all pretty just yet. New building! Oh yeah, so we can't get to parks yet, which is annoying. Oh, why is everyone crying? What's going on? Oh, guys, this is we've managed to keep our heads above the water for a little bit, but I think we may be starting to come to the end of our luck. Right, so let's get you up like that. Yes, 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 I know everything's been cut off. Calm down, love. Okay, maybe. There we go. So we're getting our area started, guys, so it's looking good. So we take a quick look from Dockside up to Lindenville, which is this forest here, and then over towards Newburgh in the distance in the farmland. So it's looking good. We've got a roundabout up here, we've got another roundabout over there, and we've got another one over there. So let me quickly end up today by starting a new little settlement up round this place here. So we can have this road it can sort of bend off that way. So this is like a really old road. Screw it, let's do that. So that's like a really old medieval road. That's like the old way in. So that's what it looks like it does now, the city. So that's like the main road. We're going to call that Whiteberg Avenue. Yes. Yes, we shall. Okay, new building. We've seen them. I just need to put some... Oh, no. Running out of money again. Well, guys, it's been a good show. Let's get some final houses in somewhere. Everyone all right up here? How's everyone doing? Yeah, we don't want anyone living on that roundabout, actually. Or along here. Get some trees behind you soon, love. Alright. Alright, love. Good stuff. Let's get a little more industry in. And then we'll call it... I just don't want to stop playing. I love this game. So I'll do a little bit off camera, guys, when I'm gone for the first episode. But that's only just so we can get some few things set up and ready for next week. Okay, so thank you guys for watching City Skylines After Dark Edition with me, Kieran. And come up with a name for next time, please. And be sure to subscribe, like, and comment if you've enjoyed this episode and want to see more. Okay, guys. Goodbye.